We will start a new topic in torsion today, and we will be solving some numericals also for torsion, how to use the torsion equation, and what are the strain energy concept in the torsion. So first of all, we'll prove that a hollow shaft is stiffer. So I'll say like this. And we'll prove hollow shaft is stiffer. Hollow shaft is stiffer. So in order to prove this, let us first say what is the stiffness. Stiffness. So stiffness of the shaft is defined by the torque which is required to produce the unit rotation in the unit length. Okay. So the stiffness of the shaft, say it is K. So we can say from torsion formula, that is T by J is equal to G theta upon L. We know this. Okay. So we if we rearrange these terms, so it is G into J into theta upon L. So if this theta upon L, that means theta is 1 and L is also 1. So that means we are having a shaft which is producing a unit angle of rotation theta and length is unit, then this torque is denoted by K and this becomes GJ. And this is known as the stiffness of the shaft. So this is the stiffness. Okay. So let KS is the stiffness for the solid shaft. Stiffness for solid shaft. Right? And let us say A hollow, AH. It is the stiffness for hollow shaft. Right? So the stiffness KS will be equal to, if we use this formula, so G and J is nothing but pi upon 32 pi upon 32 d4, where d4 is the d is the diameter of the solid shaft. Similarly, KH will be equal to G into pi upon 32, and this we can say the outer four minus dia inner to the power four. Let us write it properly. So this is the stiffness of the shaft for the solid and stiffness of shaft for hollow. now we want to compare this, so we can say kh divided by As. So this is equal to pi upon 32, pi upon 32. This will go, and we will be left with dO to the power 4 minus dI to the power 4 divided by dS to the power. Right? So this we can get. Now, this we can write d square minus di square into do square plus di square. A square minus b square into a square plus b square. Okay. And this d4, so d4 is ds to the power 4. Okay. So now we have to find the relation between the d solid and do and di. Okay, so we assume that the two shafts are of same length, and material. Only then we can compare if they are of the same length and the same material. Okay, so therefore pi by 4 into d square or ds square, this will be the area multiplied by the length and multiplied by the density. So this will give the volume into rho, so mass. Okay, so this should be equal to pi by 4 do square minus di square into L into rho. Okay, so this L rho, this will be cancelled, this will be also cancelled. So we can say it is dh square is equal to do square minus di square. So we can put this in equation number 1, the value of ds. So therefore we get ah divided by ks is equal to d 0 square minus d I square into d 0 square plus di square divided by ds square is nothing but it is 4, so it will be d 0 square minus di square, and this will be whole square. Okay. So this will, one will go from with this, so it will be equal to d 0 square plus di square डिवाइडेड बाय डीओ माइनस डीआई. सो वी हैव गॉट दिस रिलेशन बिकॉज दिस इज प्लस एंड दिस इज माइनस. सो दैट मीन्स दिस रेशियो विल बी ऑलवेज इक्वल टू मोर देन वन. So that means the stiffness of the hollow shaft will be greater than the stiffness of the solid shaft. So it is proved. Okay. So that means a hollow shaft, which is of the same weight and same length than as a solid shaft, then we will prefer the hollow shaft. And also, if you see the shear stress distribution. So, if it is a hollow shaft, the shear stress from the center, if you take, so it is like this. So, just a minute. So we take the average shear here. Say this is a solid shaft. So the shear in this case will be this. Okay. And if we take a hollow shaft, is the center. So the shear in this case will be only this. So it is taking the less shear. So that means it is a stiffer. Okay, so this is a explanation if we go by the shear stress distribution. Okay, now let us talk of what is a composite shaft. A composite shaft, like we have studied a composite member in which we have tried to solve that they take the equal strain. So a composite shaft is a shaft which is made up of two material, made up of two different material. Two different materials. Suppose this is a outer ring, and in this there is a inner ring. So say this is of steel, and the outer one it is of aluminium. So it will form a composite shaft. So let us try to solve one example by solving that what is the maximum torque, how to calculate the maximum torque in the case of a composite shaft. So I'll say example. Number one. So a composite shaft has aluminium tube. So let us say there is a composite shaft given. Okay. And this is aluminium tube. Aluminium tube. And this one. It is a steel tube or steel shaft. Okay. So a composite shaft has a aluminium tube of external dia. So given एक्सटर्नल डाया ऑफ एल्युमिनियम ट्यूब, इट इज गिवन एज 60 मिलीमीटर, एंड इंटरनल डाया गिवन एज 40 मिलीमीटर, राइट? सो इट इज क्लोजली फिटेड टू द स्टील रॉड. सो स्टील रॉड इज गिवन, सो दिस स्टील रॉड इज फिटेड इन द एल्युमिनियम ट्यूब एंड द डाया इज 40 मिलीमीटर. Right, the permissible stress is given. Permissible stress. What type of stress will be there? It will be the shear stress. Shear stress is given as 60 megapascal in aluminium. And 100 megapascal in steel, right? So we have to find the maximum torque. Find maximum torque composite shaft can take. Okay, given that G for aluminium G for aluminium, it is given as 27 kilo Newton per millimeter square, and G for steel is given as 18 kilo Newton per millimeter, right? So we have to find this. Okay, so in order to solve this, first of all you calculate the for solid shaft the value of the polar modulus or polar moment of inertia. So it is pi by 32 into d4. So d is how much here? It is 40. So 40 to the power 4. So if you solve this, it will come as 2513 27.4. So much millimeter. So for the hollow shaft, that is for this is for the steel and this is say for aluminium. J for aluminium. So it is pi by 32 and outer dia is given 60, so 60 to the power 4 minus 40 to the power 4. So this will give us 1.02, 1.02 1.02 1 8 into 10 to power 6. Millimeter 4, right? So now, because they are composite shaft, so for composite shaft, the theta, that is the angle of rotation for the steel, should be equal to the angle of rotation for the aluminum. Okay. So you can write for the steel, it will be TS into LS divided by GS, that is modulus steel, and JS. So this should be equal to T of aluminium into L of aluminium divided by G of aluminium and J of aluminium. Right. So, because the length of the steel is given is equal to length of aluminium. So this will cancel. Okay, they will be equal, so this will cancel. So you can solve this and you will find the torque carried by the steel shaft is equal to point 7293, 7293 T of aluminum. Right. So if we go by the for the steel shaft, for steel shaft, so we can write the relation as T S upon JS is equal to shear stress is given, permissible stress is given na? So tau S upon the RS. Okay, so now this RS will be the outermost point of the steel solid steel shaft. So TS will be equal to, you can put the value here, the TS tau S is given as tau S, this is tau S and this is tau aluminum. Okay, so you can write here and value of JS also we have calculated, RS will be equal to 20 here. So this we can write 251 1327 1 27.4 into 100 divided by this is tau S and this is JS divided by 20, because the shaft dia is given 40. So this is equal to 1.2566, 1.2566. So much kilo Newton meter. So this is the torque carrying capacity based on the shear criteria for the steel shaft. Okay. So for aluminium shaft, we can calculate by this relation which we have just got. So TS aluminium, TS upon 0.7. So it will be equal to TS upon 0.7293. Okay, so if you calculate this, so it will be 1.7231. So much kilonewton meter. ठीक है, तो टोटल टॉर्क विल बी हाउ मच? टोटल टॉर्क टी विल बी इक्वल टू द टॉर्क बाय द सॉलिड शाफ्ट प्लस टॉर्क बाय द एल्यूमिनियम स्टील शाफ्ट और द सॉलिड शाफ्ट. ओके, सो व्हेन यू ऐड दीज टू फिगर्स यू विल गेट 2.9797, so much kilonewton. ठीक है, so if this is based on the shear stress of the solid shell, so if the stress is if This is aluminium. Aluminium. Then T aluminium will be T by J aluminium is equal to tau aluminium. So in this case, the outermost radius. Now is given 60, so this will be 60 by 2, that is 30 RS or RF. So you can calculate from here the torque carried by aluminium is equal to, you know this value, you know this value, okay, and you know R is equal to 30, so this is equal to 2.0422 kilonewton meter. And in this case, TS will be equal to 2.0422. This we multiplied by the factor which we have calculated. That is 0.7293. So if you calculate this, it is PS is equal to 1.48939393. So much kilonewton meter. So what is the total torque? Total torque is equal to T is equal to TS plus T aluminium. So if you add these two above, so you will get 3.5315 so much kilonewton meter. Okay, so we get the two values. One is this equation number 2, and another is this equation number 3. So it is 3 point something and it is 2 point something. Okay, so we have to design the shaft based on this, which is lesser. Okay, we have to design the shaft based on the steel because it will be safe up to this torque value. And if we design based on this, then the steel shaft will break. Okay, because that is not able to carry the torque because of this. Okay, so we have to conclude that the torque value which we were supposed to calculate, the maximum torque. So we can say here the maximum torque for composite shaft maximum torque for the composite shaft is 2.9297, 2.9297, so much kilonewton meter. So this is how we design a shaft. Now, how to calculate the strain energy in torsion? The strain energy in torsion. Energy in torsion. So, when a torque T is applied to the shaft, so it gets twisted by an angle theta. T is the torque. And this shaft is twisted by angle theta, which is the angle of twist. Angle of right. So the twisting moment does the work on the shaft, and this work is stored in the shaft as the energy. So twisting moment does work and this is stored as strain energy. So strain energy we know, this is denoted by capital U. Okay. So if we draw a plot so say this is T and this is the angle of rotation theta. So if we draw a perpendicular here, so this is at maximum T and this is angle theta. So this is zero, this is theta, and this is theta. So strain energy U is equal to work done. And this is nothing but the area under this curve. Okay. So this is the area under curve. So this area is the area of the triangle. So this is equal to half base into height. So height is T and base is theta. So this is the strain energy. So we can put the value of theta over here. So half into T and this we know, it is a T into L upon GJ from the torsion formula. So this is equal to T square L upon 2 times GJ. Okay. So we can find out the say we can put the value of the T over here. So we also know that T by J from the torsion formula is equal to tau upon R. If it is solid shaft, then this T is equal to tau into J upon R. So this J value we can write T pi upon 32. R we can write D by 2. And this is D by 4. Okay. So this is equal to the strain energy. Therefore, we can find out the strain energy is equal to U is equal to half this. U is equal to half this T square. We can put the value we can use this relation first. So T square into J square upon GJ into R square. Okay. So this J will be cancelled and this we can calculate. So this will be tau into pi d cube upon 32. Okay. So this is it. So tau. So we can put the value of J here. This 2G we can write over here. And this J will be nothing but pi upon 32. Okay. Pi upon 32. This we can write the tau square upon 2. Pi upon 32. Pi upon 32. D to the power 4. And this will be equal to the this multiplied by L also tau into T square L upon 2 GJ. So T square G square GJ. So we can put these values. We can put the value of this okay. So when we'll put this value, we will get on solving pi by 16 d square into the length into tau square upon g. Right, so we can write here tau square 2g we will take out, so it will be 8g. Okay, so we'll take out 4g. It is 4g, and this will be pi d square L divided by 4 ओके इनटू टाउ स्क्वायर आ गया। सो दिस इज नथिंग बट द वॉल्यूम। सो देयरफॉर स्ट्रेन एनर्जी यू इज इक्वल टू टाउ स्क्वायर अपॉन 4g इनटू द वॉल्यूम, वॉल्यूम ऑफ शाफ्ट। सो दिस वी आर डूइंग फॉर द सॉलिड शाफ्ट, राइट। सिमिलरली वी कैन फाइंड आउट द थिंग फॉर द हॉलो शाफ्ट। ओके द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी पर यूनिट वॉल्यूम इज द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी डेंसिटी और द रेजिलेंस। ओके सो दैट यू कैन नो। सो सिमिलरली फॉर द दिस इज फॉर द दिस इज फॉर द सॉलिड शेल। सो इट इज टाउ स्क्वायर अपॉन 4g प्लस 4g इंटू वॉल्यूम। सिमिलरली फॉर हॉलो शाफ्ट, फॉर हॉलो शाफ्ट सो फॉर फाइंडिंग फॉर द हॉलो शाफ्ट वी नो दैट जे एच दैट इज पोलर मोमेंट ऑफ इनर्शिया शुड बी इक्वल टू पाई अपॉन 32 इंटू द डी ओ स्क्वायर डी ओ फोर माइनस डी आई, वेयर डी आई इज द इंटरनल डाया एंड डी ओ इज द एक्सटर्नल डाया। सो एरिया वी नो एरिया ए विल बी इक्वल टू पाई बाई फोर डी टू द पावर स्क्वायर माइनस ठीक है। सो स्ट्रेन एनर्जी स्ट्रेन एनर्जी इट इज यू इज इक्वल टू हाफ टी स्क्वायर इंटू एल अपॉन जी जे। सो दिस वी हैव डिराइव्ड इन द फर्स्ट इक्वेशन, दिस इज टी स्क्वायर एल अपॉन जी जे। ओके सो वी हैव मेड यूज ऑफ दिस इक्वेशन एंड वी कैन फाइंड आउट नाउ हियर जे। सो फॉर हॉलो शैफ्ट वील फॉर पुटिंग द हॉलो शैफ्ट वी विल से दिस विल एम्प्लाई द स्ट्रेन एनर्जी फॉर हॉलो शैफ्ट will be equal to half and this torque you will calculate for the hollow shaft. So TH hollow shaft divided by G JH into okay. So you can calculate this for getting T hollow torque hollow. So we will use the formula T hollow T by J hollow is equal to the shear stress for the hollow shaft divided by the RS. So it will be the D outer DO divided by 2. Okay, so that means this will imply the torque for the hollow shaft is equal to 2 times divided by 2 times into JH divided by G. So this you put in this equation number. This was equation number we have known. So let this equation is 1, Let this equation is 2, and let this equation is 3. So put in equation 3. Put in equation 3. So you will get UH is equal to of T square, TH square into L. So TH square is this. So 2 times tau H into JH divided by D0, this whole square into L divided by G into JH. So one JH will go, and you put the another thing. So you will get here the strain energy UH will be equal to T so you can use this, and you can straight away use this. Otherwise, you put the these values, and strain energy per unit volume will be equal to in the terms of the solid shaft, this square divided by 4g multiplied by d1 square or d o square plus d I square divided by d o square. Right? So this is the final relation we will get for the strain energy. So I think we have covered a lot in this chapter. So I thank you very much for your patient listening. We'll be making use of this energy concept in our next chapter. So thank you so much.